Hey everyone, today I have another 90s nostalgia review and I haven't done one of these in quite a while, but tomorrow there will be one and also possibly Saturday as well, I think, or maybe Sunday. I really do like doing these, but I only ever do them if there's nothing else to talk about, you know, and it seems that this week has had very little new TV shows introduced into my life. There have been good things on TV, it's just like repeats of things I've seen before and things I've already talked about, which gives me the perfect opportunity to talk about Zap. Now this has been requested quite a bit, which makes me think it was a lot more popular than what I believed it to be. I loved this as a child, but I didn't really know anybody else who watched it, and I never really talked to anybody who's seen it before. So this will be quite interesting to see if you've seen it and just how much you remember of it. I watched three clips prior to recording this video. I watched three clips this morning, and it's pretty much how I remembered it. There were one or two features which were not exactly as I recalled them, but other than that, it's pretty clear in my mind. Now just a couple of facts for you. This started in 1993, the year after I was born, and ran until 2001. That's pretty impressive. I honestly thought it maybe stopped around about 97 at the most, so I'm quite shocked to see that it's ran for so long. And there were 131 episodes. I could remember maybe three. I'm like, how many? That's ridiculous! I just can't believe there were so many episodes. I thought maybe 20 at the most, so I'm really quite impressed with this show, and that kind of gives me an indication that it perhaps was a bit more popular than what people I know are suggesting it is. But it's kind of like a little sketch show. It lasts around about 15 minutes each per episode, and it starts off with this comic book, and it's this giant, well, it starts off with a real comic book, and then it turns into a giant cartoon comic book with a giant remote, and on the front of this comic book there are 9 squares, I think. And in each 9 square, each square is kind of like a window. And there's something new and exciting in each one. My favourite one, I think, holds no benefit to the sketches themselves, but it's like a leg with a... How do you say singular of tights? Because there's only one leg, so it's not a pair of tights. Anyway, we'll say stocking. There's a leg with a striped stocking on it, and it's just swinging back and forth. And that amuses me so much, and it kind of gives me an indication of just how psychedelic parts of this programme are. Really quite interesting. There are various features, I've written a couple of them down, but there are a couple of others. There's Cuthbert Lilly, and his tagline is, "He's dead silly." And his 3-minute little section, his little sketch, if you like, is pretty much slapstick humour. I don't really like slapstick, so I'm not a massive fan of that particular stint. But it's quite appealing, you can see how funny it would be. And he has a dog as well. His dog's probably the highlight of his sketches, which I did like as a child, and I still do. You have Smarty Artie, which is with Neil Buchanan. Did I know that in my childhood? I don't know. I probably didn't. He doesn't really look like Neil Buchanan when he's playing this character. But basically, that sketch is a big Art Attack. If you're a fan of Art Attack and you know who Neil Buchanan is, he did a feature at the end of every Art Attack called The Big Art Attack, you know? And where he'd make a big picture out of loads of stuff. And Smarty Artie's sketch is basically a big Art Attack. That's kind of what it is, which is something you can relate to if you're an Art Attack fan, and I really do like that as well. Very entertaining, very fun, and the character's a little bit annoying, but it's quite interesting at the same time. Then you have Tricky Dicky, which is a kind of Sherlock Holmes kind of character. Part of it's in black and white, which I think is nice, you know, introducing 20th century kids to black and white element, you know? Well, late 20th century kids to the black and white element, because they perhaps haven't seen it prior to that, so that's quite nice. Unless you watch the Rugrats, it's an episode of the Rugrats which is all in black and white, it's quite weird. And the last one I've written down, which is partly my favourite and partly the one I hate the most, is the Handymen, and they are just two hands, gloved hands. I remember them being quite masculine hands, but I've just watched a couple of clips and they seem to be females' hands, I'm not sure. And they're gloved, and one's blue and one's yellow. And they just do different things with the hands. They may paint a finger picture or... Did that sound right? Did I say the right P and the F in the right way? I think I did. They may paint a finger picture, just in case I didn't. Or do something like that, just with their hands, so you can't see who's behind them. And it's really nice, and it almost introduces the element of sort of finger puppets, if you like, of doing things with your hands and using your hands to be quite creative, and I quite enjoyed that. The only thing is, it gave me nightmares. When I was younger, I had this dream, and I can still remember it. I was in this house with my grandma, and she's like, come on, we'll go outside and we'll play with the remote control car track. I didn't know a remote control car track, but when we went outside in the dream, there was big, massive remote control cars and a big, massive racetrack. I don't know. But before that, I said, okay, I'll just be a second, I'm just finishing up. And I went like that with my hands, and I went like that, and there was glue on my hands. Perhaps during that day I'd been using Pritt-Stick or something and got a bit on my hands, I don't know. And as I peeled back the glue in the dream, beneath my skin, like where the patches of glue were, when I peeled off those patches of glue, beneath my skin was blue and yellow. It was really peculiar. And what, could have been 5 or something, maybe even less? And that stayed with me for this long, you know, 15 years plus. It's a little bit scary, and that kind of shows that Zap has given me a lifelong nightmare, and it's very terrifying. But other than that, it is really great, and it is quite interesting to have these little sketches. Probably would have been the first sketch show I was introduced to. Whether or not you want to call it a sketch show, it's up to you, but I personally think it would fit that category quite well. It aired on CITV, and CITV was, when I was younger, sort of the queen of all, you know, kids' TV shows. This was before CBeebies. I think CBeebies may have just celebrated its 10th birthday. It's had some birthday anyway. So CBeebies wasn't around when I was younger. BBC obviously did kids' shows, but to me, ITV reigned with the kids' TV before cable television. If you've never seen it, go on YouTube. There are plenty of clips on YouTube. It is just fantastic. It's really peculiar, and it just goes against quite a lot of things that I believe in, but I absolutely love it. You know, the nostalgic effect there is great, even though it gave me nightmares. Plus, I really like the onomatopoeic title of the show, Zap. It's very weird, although you don't need to kind of have the three Z's there to make it onomatopoeic, but never mind, that's just me being awkward with language. But please feel free to leave comments and let me know your thoughts on this. Tomorrow's video will be Meow Meow, which is great. I love that programme. And I'll see you all next time. Bye.